Hello guys, KP Shamino here with a new video for Fishing Planet, and I'm going to explain to you guys the bottom fishing in this game, because it's not always easy, because it's typical Europe thing. I did it in my life like 10-15 times maybe, so I'm not really an expert in it, but I'm going to try to you guys to explain what I know. So always remember, in fishing you cannot do really anything wrong. So always remember that, because I always see guys that say you need to use it like that. That no, I still remember when I was young and I went to fish with my uncles. We did so many silly things, like going with four hooks with a bobber. So in fishing you can do what you want. That you are going to catch fish, that's another story. But you can always do what you want in fishing. Always remember that. But if you play, of course, a game, you're always going to be limited what the game is going to bring you. So I'm going to give you guys an overview about the bottom fishing, how we need to use it, for what it is used in the game, and all that stuff. So I'm going to talk about everything. So let's get started. First of all, the bottom fishing in this game is... You can do it with three setups. So that's feeder fishing, that's with bottom fishing, and that's with carp fishing. So you got three rods to that, going to do that. They are the feeder rods, the bottom rods, and the carp rods. That's what you can use to do bottom fishing. So first of all, you got feeder rods. So you will see if you go to the shop, the feeder rods. Oh, minus two, place 20. What the fuck? So if you go to the feeder rods, you will see that the highest test, so the heaviest one, is level 27 and it only goes to 9 kilograms. So feeder rods, most of the time are used for smelly, very small fish, like bream, barbel, small carp, the drum. You can use it on the walleye. For that, it's perfect. So if you see a competition for bream, most of the time you're going to need to use a feeder rod. Feeder rods, they got a quiver too. So what is the quiver? It's like a tip that you put on the feeder rod. And it's going to bend. And if it bends, you know that you got a bite. That's very simple. That's how it is. So what can you do with the feeder rod? I will show you guys it for a brief moment. You just need to go, here I got the feeder rod. So you can use sinkers, very simple sinkers. So that's just the bottom weight. You can use, I'm going a little bit down here, the closed feeders. That's going to work too. You can use the open feeders. So that are the three things that you can use on a feeder rod. That's very important. And then the other things that you can use too, you can use all the baits on it. So except the pellets and the boilies. You cannot use those on a feeder rod. So you can just put ground bait in it. You can just go for small fish. Be very aware, always be sure that you don't go over the weight that your rod can handle. Because with other rods for bottom fishing, you're not going to break your rod. But if you go over the weight, as I just did, so let's go back to here. So with the feeder, so you guys, tackle is too heavy and can break the line while casting. You're going to break your quiver if you do this. So always be aware that you don't break your quiver. That's very important because it's very sensitive. This one is 142 gram, but I already broke one. You're going to throw in and you're going to break it. So you can put bells on it too on a feeder. Yeah, it's not really needed because you can do it with the quiver, but in this game you can put bells on it. So for very small fish, you can use feeders on it, you can use a sinker on it, you can use all the weights on it. But you cannot use boilies and you cannot use pellets. Another thing that I want to say to you guys is you always need to fish with the leader. So in the best case, the leader always needs to be the weakest link of your setup. Because if you get spooled, it's always better that you break your leader. Because if you break your line, if you break your leader, you're going to lose this. If you break your line, you're going to lose all of this. It's like a chain. This is first, then that. So you always need to break the last part of your setup. Otherwise, it's just more expensive. That's how simple it is. What kind of letters can you use on a feeder rod? That's all the letters except the carb letters. They are not going to work on it. So that's the feeder setup. Very small fish. I like to fish with it. Then you got you can work with your leader too, but I don't know what you need to do with that. I know that 50 centimeter is for small for carp, so I guess that the bait need to be very close to the feeding. So the closer that you make your leader, the closer the hook is to the feeding place. What I know too is that if you go with live bait, it's better that you got a longer leader so that the live bait can swim around. So that's only what I know. I'm not an expert on the leaders. I don't bother a lot with the leaders. I never saw different, to be honest, in the game. So that's the feeder setup. A little bit later, I'm going to show you guys how we need to fish with it in Texas. So that was first feeder. That's the first time that you are going to use it. You can put it in a rod pot too. So what are rod pots? I will show you guys really quick. So you're going to find it here. So this is a rod stand, they call it. So a rod stand is very easy. You just put, you throw your feeder in it, in the water. You put your rod in the rod pot and then you can wait. So you, that's how you can fish with more than one rod. So, simply said, always be aware, the first three you need ground, you cannot put it on the dock. This one you can just put where you want. This is ground again. And you got bite alarms. So, if you got bite alarms, you don't need to use bells. If you don't have bite alarms, you need to use bells to see the bite. Otherwise, it doesn't work. Okay, so now to the next step, the bottom rods. So, you will see that the bottom rods are a lot heavier. So, for what can you use bottom rods? You can use bottom rods for heavy fish, like sturgeon, like catfish, like carp too. But there is one major problem with the bottom rods. I will show you guys when I go to the inventory. So, I use this for everything except carp. So, in the game, the chinooks you can catch with it, everything that got a very big weight, because you can see now the test here is already 27 kilogram for the biggest one, and the smallest started 21.5 kilogram. So, this is purely used for all the fish beside the carp. You can fish on the carp too, but I would not buy it to fish for carp. I would buy a carp rod to fish for carp. So, I cannot say more about it, that's the bottom. Most of the time you use a sinker on it, but you can use the feeders on it too, and I will show you guys that right away. So here you see a setup, you can put a bell on it too. So you can fish it with your hand. So if you go to a competition, you can fish with this. So you can use a sinker, here you can see it. You can use normal leaders too, but you cannot use the carp leaders. Carp leaders you only can use on carp rods, not on bottom rods. What can you use here on two? That's the feeders. So, feeders. You can use the feeders, closed feeder and open feeder. So that's what you can do. So you can fish with ground bait. You can just fish with a sinker and with like a minnow or a shiner. Because you can use everything. All baits on this one, except boilies again and pellets. But you can use sweet corn, sweet peas, peas and corn, pea dough. So you can use this for carp too. But I like to use it sometimes for carp, but the pellets and the boilies are so good compared to this that most of the time I use carp rods for carp, because carp rods, yeah, the name is saying it. I cannot say more about this. So if you go to sturgeon, if you want to farm sturgeon, if you want to farm blue catfish, if you want to go for the beluga, if you want to go for the Welsh catfish, always go with this, because you cannot put on the carp rods the bait that you need to use. It's very simple. So you need this. So that are the bottom rods. You can put a bell on it too. I already said that you can play a little bit with a leader. So that's it. Now we are going to the last part, and that's the most it's not complicated, but The carp rods, they give like a lot of setups that you can make. Yeah, not a lot. It's only three, I think. So, but it's, I think for the most people, the most complicated. So if you go for the carp, so carp fishing is a very big deal in Europe. So I don't understand why Americans always want to kill carp, because it's a very strong fish. It's very fun to fish for carp because they give a very nice fight. And for me, they look very nice too. If you see the koi carps, to give you guys an example, if you got a koi carp that got the flag of Japan, you can sell that one for, I think, a couple of thousand euros, maybe, I think, tens of thousands of euros. So that's how beautiful they are. I like the carp, but yeah, maybe it's a Europe thing, but I don't have a problem with them. So here you see the carp rods. So they are very heavy. So the heaviest one is this one. That's 26.5. You can put a lot of weight on them. So they are designed for carp fishing. With the last update, they came into the game, and that's normal. The UK lake is a carp lake. So you can see it here. If you want to go for carp, you can buy it. But to be honest, I would not buy a carp rod before you go to the UK, to be honest. Because, okay, you can go for carp in California. Okay. But yeah, it's so limited. It's an American lake, so it's limited to carp fishing there. You can get nice carp. The common carp is over there. You can try it in Germany too, but I tested Germany. It's, do you need to buy a new rod for it? Because you only can use this. You can only use boilies and pellets on this one. So you cannot use something else on it. I would not suggest to do it. You need to buy it when you go to the UK. Of course, you can do what you want. The first one you can buy at 35 without bait coins. But yeah, where are you going to use it? I don't know. I don't know. I think the UK lake is the lake that you need to use this. But that's just an opinion, guys. You can do what you want. It's a game. I'm not... I'm a liberal in my head. And I always live like liberal. So everybody can do what he wants in the game. So... these are the carp rods. So I got already a couple of carp rods. So what can you do with the carp rods? So first of all, you can use a sinker. But you cannot use any more the feeders. That's done. So the two other one, you could use the feeders. But if I now scroll over the feeders, they are gray. That's how you can see. People always ask me, I cannot equip it. No, if it is gray, you simply cannot use it. That's how simple it is. So you guys can see it, so I cannot use this, but you can use other stuff. So you got the method, that's this one, that you can use, and you can use the PVA. So recap, you can use sinkers, you can use PVA, and you can use the method. That's the three things that you can use on a carp rod. That's typical for carp fishing. Okay, so if you want to know how you need to do method and PVA, just check my video. I got a video that is only going to talk about that stuff. I'm not going to repeat it. You can just watch the video. Just type it in YouTube, method KP Shamino, and you will see my video. So very important, on a carp rod, you can only use carp leaders. So it's done with the mono leaders. So it's only carp leaders that you can use. You can use all the hooks on a carp rod. That's not a problem. You guys will see it here. But I would suggest that you use the carp hooks. Why? Because a carp is very quick spooked. They always told me that. I don't know that from real life. But I think that's why they implemented the carp hooks in the game. You only can use carp hooks on a carp rod. So if you go back to the bottom rods, you see it's gray. If you go back to the feeder, it's gray. So you cannot use it. So if you want to do a PVA, I can do it really quick for you. You just do this. Then you need to get a sinker. You do this. And here you put the ground bait. So if you want to use the method one, you just need to go to this. I will do it really quick for you guys. That... where is the method? Here is the method. Here you go. So now you're using the method and you put it full with ground bait. So on a carp rod, recap, simple sinkers, method, PVA, That's what you can use on it. I hope that I didn't forget one thing. I'm going to check it really quick because I don't want to forget. So we got PVA, we got method, decay, sinker. Yeah, that's it. Okay. Now that we are here, here you can see the common bells. So you can buy, it's just, they are, why is this higher level and more currency worth? It's just more sensitive. So you're going to see the byte a little bit better. Okay. So another thing, I totally forgot about it. You cannot use anymore on the carp rods normal baits. So you guys can see it here. What can you use? Corn, peas, sweet corns, and bolis and pellets. So you can only use that on carp. So don't buy a carp rod to go for sturgeon with spawn sack because it's not going to work. So that's it. So you guys know now how it works. It's not that complicated, but if you see it at the start, you think, oh, what the fuck, I just bought something, I cannot use the pellets. So yeah, it's not that easy at the start. Now we are going to talk about ground bait because that's the most important about bottom fishing. Because why is bottom fishing so good for carp? Because they are like cows, they eat the whole day and you can just feed on one position. And your bait is in the ground bait where the fish is feeding. So it's going to attract the fish, takes it, and you got the fish. So ground bait in this game, you just go to this area. You can just click this away. So what do you got in this game? So if you go back to the shop, you guys can see here you got ground bait bases. So that's just a base. So you just put it in. If you click on it, everything, all the info is here. I'm not really a hero in this part. I try some stuff, but it's very hard to know what is good and what is bad. So if you click on it, this is important. Temperature is very important. So if you got like low temperature, like 14, 15 Celsius, and you go with ground bait that needs warm temperature, it's not going to work that well. So this is a normal one. So I can buy maybe one bag for you guys just to show it. So let's buy the Crimson Gold water. So let's buy this one. So that's the base. Then you got the bolis and the pellets. So that's over here that you can buy. So if you go with bolis and pellets, it's best that you buy this one. You can put it in your method and your PVA. I'm not really sure that I can put it in a cage. I don't think so because the feeder is over here. So this is the feeders that you can use it. Then the next one is the method. This is specially for method. So don't buy ground bait that is not for method if you fish with method because you simply cannot put it in the method. Then we got the particles that you can use, so you can just buy it. I'm going to buy this bag. And then you got the aromas. So the aromas is most of the time liquid that you put in it, and it's going to give an aroma. Always be aware, don't put too much aroma in it because there is big difference by attraction and bad smelling. So sometimes you can just spook the fish away too with too much smell. So always watch that. I got a tutti frutti here already. So if you go now back, so how do you do it? You just come to here. So I want to put the base in it. So let's take 1 kilogram. Then you just take a particle that's over here. Then you got like the aroma that you put in that's over here. Yeah, and this bottle is empty. Okay. And then you just need to mix it, and then you got your ground bait. So if I mix this, yeah, you must be at the pond. Yeah, that's a pity. So if you mix it, you're going to get over here in your inventory, you're going to get ground bait over here. And then you can just, scroll it in this area. I cannot show you guys it. Maybe I can do it if we go to the pond. And then it's going to be active. So always be aware. Methods, they need special ground bait under method feeders too, under feeders. The bolis you can put, I think, in everything. I'm not sure. You guys need to watch it yourself because I didn't test that thing. So I started to think in the video, but I'm not sure about it. So Yeah, that's how you need to do ground bait, guys. So now we are going really quick to the pond. I'm not sure that I can catch a fish, but I can show you guys maybe how we need to do it. I'm going to Lone Star because the main problem is I don't want to go to the UK because it's going to cost me a shitload of money. I'm not even sure that there is still fish over here, but I can show you guys maybe how you need to do it with the feeders. A little bit info. Okay, we are now here, and first of all, we are going to make a little bit more, yeah, light. Yeah, that's not really. So now I got the feeder in my hands. So this is the feeder setup. This is my bream setup. So you guys can already see. Can I zoom in? No. So you see that my quiver is bending a lot. So how do you fish with it? You just throw it in the water. I'm not sure that I'm going to catch a fish. I don't think so, because you only got the buffalo over here. And what I do is, I just do a small reel. And you see the quiver going? So the quiver is now already a little bit benching. So I don't need to do this, because when my bill is going, I'm going to get a bite. So, and now you just need to wait. And if you hear the bells, you need to wait, you need to wait. Your tension is going up, and the moment that your tension is going very fast up, you can strike. But you need to wait. Just practice a little bit with it, and you will do fine. So, then for the bottom rods, that's just the same. I cannot say more bottom rod. You just need to do the same, but you don't have the quiver. But it's not really a problem here. So this is the bottom rod. So you can do just the same. But it's not bending because it's not getting a quiver. Then for the carp rod, you cannot put bells on a carp rod. So most of the time you can fish it with the hand too. But it's not easy. You always need to keep watching your stuff. Because you cannot put a bell on it. So this is made for bite indicators, rod pot. So how can I see that I got a bite? So at the right over here, yeah, there is the mouse. So if this started to become blue, I know there is a fish nibbling. You never, but you always need to watch it. So it's not that you can throw it in the water and just say, yeah, I'm going AFK and I hear the bells. No, you cannot put bells on a carp rod. But of course, what is easier, you just buy yourself this, the rod pot. But that's a high level. I think the first one is at level 43. So the rod pot, that's with number 9. Then you put it on the ground. You can move it a little bit higher, a little bit lower. So you just throw it in the water. Then if it is in the water, you do control 1. If I want to pick it back up, I do control 1 again. That's how you do it. You don't need to put strength on the line. The line is getting yeah, nicely, automatically. You guys can see it. I can do this with the feeder too. You just throw it somewhere. I do control 2. And here we go. And now you just need to wait. And if it starts beeping, you need to watch your line. You just zoom in. And then you strike, and that's how you do it. So it's a lot of information, guys. I hope it helps you guys a lot. So if you buy a carp rod, be sure that you got a bite indicator rod pot, because otherwise it's very hard to fish. The feeder fishing you can do already early in the game. Bottom fishing is for the big fish. Carp fishing is, carp rods are for carps. That's how it is. I hope it helps you guys a little bit. It's a lot of info that I gave to you guys. Maybe I forgot something. You always can ask under the video in comments. So thanks for watching, guys. Have fun with bottom fishing. It's a very nice part of fishing. I like it a lot. So it's something from Europe. Thanks for watching. Have fun. Bye bye.